हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू फिजिकल एजुकेशन क्लास। आई होप यू ऑल आर फिजिकली फिट एंड सेफ एट योर होम। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, माय नेम इज शमशेर सिंह, फिजिकल एजुकेशन टीचर फ्रॉम कैम्ब्रिज इंटरनेशनल स्कूल दसुआ। As we discussed about chapter number 5, yoga. Topics were meaning of yoga and importance of yoga. I hope you have understood these topics. Now we will start with next term, elements of yoga. Dear students, this topic is very important, so please listen carefully. Let's start the elements of yoga. The elements of yoga has been described as Ashtanga yoga, which is derived from the two Sanskrit words. First is Astha, which means eight, and second is Ang, which means limbs. Therefore, Ashtanga Yoga is also known as eight-limbed yoga or Hatha Yoga. The elements of yoga are described below. There are eight elements of yoga. First is Yama. Second is Niyama. Third is Asana. Fourth is Pranayama. Fifth is Pratyahara. Sixth is Dharana. Seventh is Dhyana. And last is Samadhi. First point is Yamas. The yamas are practiced to eliminate wrong, harmful or disturbing behavior. They create a foundation of right living, peace and harmony. There are five yamas which are as given below. First is Ahimsa. Ahimsa means non-violence. It means to shun all the acts of violence which cause harm to others. Violence includes not only the physical harm but also mental harm. Second is Satya. Satya means truthfulness. It means to be truthful in thought, word, and deed. We must not lie. Third is Asatya. Asatya means non-stealing. It means non-stealing. Stealing is a crime both legally and morally. Next is Brahmacharya. It means to keep one's sense organs under control. Brahmacharya also evokes a sense of directing our energy away from external desires towards finding peace and happiness within ourselves. Last point is Aparigraha. Aparigraha means non-coveting. Aparigraha teaches us to live with minimum things which are enough to sustain a life. We should not desire for physical or material pleasures. Second element is Niyama. The niyamas are in word practice to improve the self. It contains 5 essential techniques. They are, first is socha. Socha means purification. One should acquire clean habits in every field of life. One should also keep his mind clean by avoiding passion, anger, greed, pride, and jealousy, which may lead to the development of abnormal behavior. Second is Santosha. Santosha means to maintain a balanced attitude whatever we do. To remain upperturbed through all of life's ups and downs is true contentment. Santosha. To be even-minded in all actions and throughout all of life's experiences is the key to our success. Third is tapas. It refers to a steady application of the will to achieve a meaningful goal, which implies being able to sacrifice lesser pursuits along the way to continue to work towards and achieve a higher consciousness. We must remain steady in our exercise of tapas. Svadhyaya. Svadhyaya means do an introspection of what we have done in the past and what have been the results of our different efforts, and then they to rectify our mistakes by acting in the right way of future. Last is Ishvara Pranidhana. To attain peace and sense of community. It is always better to dedicate the actions and the fruits of our actions to God Almighty. Bete, socha means purity and cleanliness. Santosha means contentment. Tapas means self-discipline. Svadhyaya means self-study. Ishvara Pranidhana means surrender to the divine will. Third point is asanas. Asanas consist of physical postures and movements to release tension, remove toxins, and prepare the mind for meditation. It is the first stage of personal practice aimed at the physical body. The foundation of all that we do in life. The practitioner can learn about the workings of their minds and the obstacles created from past experience. Asanas can then become a kind of meditation. There are various types of asanas, such as corrective asanas, relaxative asanas, and meditative asanas. Next point is pranayama. Pranayama improves the respiratory system. Regular practice helps to control the mind and emotions. Pranayama is the fourth step of Ashtanga Yoga. Pranayama is the practice of various breathing techniques. There are three main stages of pranayama. First is puraka. Puraka means to inhale breath. Second is kumbhaka. Kumbhaka means to retain breath. And third is richaka. Richaka means to exhale breath. Dear students, इसमें क्या करना है, सांस को अंदर लेके जाना है, फिर उसको होल्ड करना है. इनहेल, फर्स्ट इनहेल, देन रिटेन, उसको रोकना है अंदर मैक्सिमम टाइम, देन एक्सहेल. इनहेल इन योर नोज एंड एक्सहेल इन योर माउथ. फॉलोइंग आर द फ्यू इम्पोर्टेंट क्रियाज ऑफ प्राणायाम. सूर्य वेदी प्राणायामा, उजाई प्राणायामा, शीतकारी प्राणायामा, शीताली प्राणायामा, भ्रस्तिका प्राणायामा एंड कपाल भाती प्राणायामा. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज प्रत्याहारा. प्रत्याहारा रेफर्स टू वेरियस मेथड्स ऑफ मैनेजिंग इम्प्रेशंस एंड कंट्रोलिंग द सेंसेस दैट आर आवर मेन सोर्सेज ऑफ कंटेक्ट विद द एक्सटर्नल वर्ल्ड. वट एवर वी टेक इन थ्रू द सेंस अफेक्ट्स द माइंड. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज धारणा. धारणा इज द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ माइंड. इन धारणा One is able to control self or mind completely. He is concentrated wholly on a single point or on a task in which he is completely engrossed. Dharana is the first step towards samadhi. In fact, Dharana is a mental exercise which enables a yogi to go ahead towards dhyana and samadhi. Next point is dhyana. Dhyana or meditation is the seventh element of yoga. Dhyana is the process of complete concentration of mind, and one can concentrate long and do meditation. It is the stage prior to samadhi. In this condition, one is able to integrate body, control over breath, senses, mind, ego, etc. In fact, dhyana is a complete concentration of mind over a period of time without any divergence. Last element of yoga is samadhi. Samadhi is the stage in which one loses personal identity. It is the peak of meditation. It is the union of individual's soul with the supreme soul. Person remains in the state of samadhi and his senses are at rest as one is sleeping, but his mind remains alert. In this state, one is fully conscious and alert. Dear students, all these elements help to improve the individual's physical health, mental, emotional, moral qualities, social qualities, and spiritual balance. The personality of the individuals is developed and one is able to live long and enjoy life. Dear students, you can start yoga at home. If you have any queries regarding asanas, regarding topics, you can call me, you can message me. At the end, stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Thanks for joining me.